Thanks, Ed. Well, this ceremony was to be a tribute to the way Manchester United always have fought back under Alex Ferguson, how his rhetoric a year ago inspired his traumatised players at Sunderland who had seen Manchester City grab the winners' medals from United hands. And it is still that way, but no one could have imagined it would be a farewell party as well. The senior staff, Eric Steele, the goalkeeping coach, Tony Strudwick there, who does so much for the fitness, Rob Swire, the physio, Albert Morgan, the long-serving kit man, all men who feel privileged to have worked under Alex Ferguson.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome, led by manager Alex Ferguson.
Just a little bit refreshed after his emotional speech, and accompanied by Mike Phelan, the manager. Part of his mantra was that he never looked back. It was always the next game, the next challenge he focused on. But he's got one more game away to West Bromwich Albion. And after that, in a week's time, he will have the chance to reflect on his life's work, the greatest managerial career of all. And here they come, his latest group of champions. At the bounce. Unforgettable moments to be treasured. Even at Manchester United, you can't be sure they will be repeated, although that often has been the case. And the first medal goes to the outgoing manager, his 13th. So Dave Richards, the chairman of the Premier League, with John Winter as the chief executive of Barclays Corporate. Barclays, the sponsors, of course, of the Premier League. He is a Manchester United fan. Well, the players will sort out their own order. Michael Carrick has had such an amazing season. Nominated in the player's choice for the player of the year. Rio Ferdinand, 6 Premier League winners' medal. A medal and a hug from the manager. Javier Hernandez, who scored today in this latest 2-1 win, the last home win under Alex Ferguson. Anderson, who's a very popular member of the staff, doesn't always play, of course, a cheerful character. Danny Welbeck, sure, will be hoping that many more of these moments to come still at the start of his career. So is Phil Jones, who gets this as his first major honour. He started the last 8 games too. Anders Lindegaard, for most of the season, the backup goalkeeper, but not all of it. He had a spell as first choice. And Wayne Rooney not involved today. One wonders what his future will hold, but no indication of any difficulties there. And of course, he's played under David Moyes before. Alex Butner gets a medal, although he's only made 4 appearances. They've changed the regulations this season. We haven't seen too much of Nani either. He's had some injuries and been out of favour. David De Gea, another first honour with the club. Rafael, who missed out today in the match through suspension, he's had a very good season, probably his best so far. And certainly Robin van Persie, who turned his back on Arsenal, a club he loved very much, we shouldn't forget that, for the chance to win honours here, and he's not been disappointed. Paul Scholes, we want to get this done, get out of it, get home. Put his feet up, have a cup of tea. 11 Premier League winners' medals. Antonio Valencia played his 100th Premier League game today in this success. Tom Cleverley, another representative of the future of Manchester United. The first player from Japan to win a medal, Shinji Kagawa. Ryan Giggs, who could do this in his sleep. 13 now. Incredible, absolutely incredible. Johnny Evans about to get married at the end of the season. Ashley Young, who's had to sit it out, as you can see, because of an ankle problem. And Chris Smalling as well. Well, Patrice Evra has stood in as the vice-captain. Very strong voice in the dressing room. Influential Frenchman. He's added goals to his game this season. And the captain. Fifth Premier League title for Nemanja Vidic. So this is the presentation, and we wonder whether the manager will be involved. And the players want him to raise it. Leaving on a high. The curtain comes down, but the trophy goes up. Going out in yet another blaze of glory. Going out on top as manager of the champions.
Michael, what a special moment that was.
Unbelievable. I mean, it's happened 13 times in his time, but every time is special. I mean, this is, I mean, to be this close without being involved is the first time for me, but to be this close, you actually feel it. Did you not do that?
Can it bring it all back, right?
Well, it does. I mean, I've been very fortunate to play at this place, and, you know, looking at those scenes and the pictures here, tells it all, really. It's just a fantastic occasion, and it's a great feeling for any player.
I said these are the greatest days of your life as a football player, winning the championship. They happen very, very few and far between, but for those younger players, the likes of De Gea and Raphael and Phil Jones, are special, special moments. It really are.
What about the other end of the scale, Gary? You caught a little word with Ryan Giggs before he went up, when it's number 13, and for Paul Scholes when it's number 11. Does it get all the more sweet?
Well, they just keep on going. It's like Martin said in his line when he was, it's normal for them players to continue to win championships. They keep coming back year after year after year, and the manager, I have to say, is a huge part of that. He sets the tone right the way through the football club. Next year, Ryan Giggs will be in that dressing room. David Moyes is going to be the manager. He has got the perfect dressing room manager in Ryan Giggs, and I'm sure he's somebody that he'll get on side straight away, because the mentality through that dressing room, he makes sure those lads never step out of line in there.
That's right, isn't it, Dwight? Ryan Giggs still got a big part to play at this football club.
Absolutely, and what an important play as well. You know, his football has been fantastic this season. And, you know, even though he's taken a little bit reserved there, but he will be enjoying it. And he knows that, you know that the team needs to go forward. And that's exactly what will happen with David Moyes coming in, the new manager. And, you know, it's good to have people like Ryan Giggs around. And I'm sure they'll be in good stead.
And as they celebrate, Peter, is that his greatest achievement to Alex Ferguson and Steve Bruce and Brian Robson? Come over to join us. It all started back in 93, the fact he's done it over and over.
Actually, it started this end. Bruce's scored two goals here that actually turned it our way. We were 1-0 down to Sheffield Wednesday, and for some reason he turned up and scored two goals. Absolutely fantastic. And that's why the two guys ended up lifting that trophy.
Steve, do you still remember those goals? Those goals that Peter refers to, those famous goals he scored at this end, the header in particular?
20 years ago, can you believe it? And by the look of him, it looks 20 years ago.
And with you coming back to the Premier League, and congratulations with that.
Thank you.
It's going to be a different place, isn't it, now, without that man, Sir Alex?
Well, I came back 15 times over the last 15 years and never got a result. So this time, it might be possible, I don't know, but it certainly might be a bit easier with him out the road anyway.
It's going to be different, though, isn't it, Brian, with no Sir Alex on the touchline?
No, it's going to be totally different, but congratulations to Brucey as well for getting promotion. But it's brilliant that the lads have achieved what they've achieved this year, you know, after so many years going without the title, and the boss to get 20 titles. Yeah, you know, this is great for the club.
And you personally, it reminded us, of course, of 1993, that iconic moment. What was it like to come back out here with the trophy once again?
It's fantastic to walk out here, you know, in this stadium and that. But it was just great that in 92, 93, Yes, the lads were involved in it, and I think that was the icing on the cake where we broke the shackles and it went on to get the success that the bus has had over the last few years.
Gentlemen, for the moment, thanks very much indeed. That moment back in 93 set it all off, and what a roll it's been. And they've won it again. A historic moment at Old Trafford this afternoon. Sir Alex bows out as a champion.